With their finals chances on a knife edge, Fremantle rolled the dice and played Aaron Sandilands. It was a ruckman's first game in 11 against a Carlton outfit desperate to shore up fourth spot and the finals double chance. It was a fast start at Paterson Stadium and Matthew Pavlich was centre stage.
Pavlich, this would be the perfect start, looks up, needs to kick it himself.
The reply came quickly through a Blues danger man.
Betts might make something of it regardless, and it's all square.
Betts was proving elusive, his second had the Dockers worried.
Strikes that beautifully and signals to the crowd.
Carlton slammed on three before Zach Clark led the way for Frio, a strong mark and a good kick.
He's got it all, and that was a much needed strike.
Pete Scotland and Ryan Crowley got acquainted. The Docker got a free kick for his efforts as the game tightened up when Alex Silvani repaid the faith up forward.
From 50, it's a tumbler. It's the best ugly kick you'll see.
By the first break, though, Carlton were on top. A goal after the siren to Bryce Gibbs had his side up by 17 points. The visitors should have been further ahead, but poor kicking kept Frio within striking distance.
Sprays it, they should be a lot further in front.
Betts was improving the ledger, putting some distance between the sides.
Opens the angle up, never in doubt.
With little more than 2 minutes to go for the quarter, Ballantyne provided a spark.
It bounces, Sandilands made it his. If anybody can, Hayden Ballantyne can.
Once again, though, Betts was on the spot, reclaiming all the momentum heading into half-time.
And in the shadows of half-time, Carlton lead by 26.
Brownlow medal favourite Judd opened the scoring in the third.
Pavlich can't trap it. Judd does trap it. Goes for goal.
Fremantle's finals hopes sinking fast.
Thornton runs around.
The game slipping away for Mark Harvey, his charges mesmerised as Garlett's kick rolled through.
Gets a handball out to Garlett. Outside of the boot, it's all about the bounce. Oh, Broughton waited for it.
He did.
The home fans finally had something to cheer about when Michael Johnson broke the drought.
It's been good all afternoon and he's good here.
The cheers turned to roars when Crowley slipped one through.
Hands up to Crowley. Bounced it to him.
And then Tendai Mazungu backed himself.
Mazungu needs to go for goal. We talked about it earlier. Finally, he nails one. Three in a row and they're back.
A 25-point game, but Andrew Walker had the final say.
Walker! Skywalker again!
He's doing it on a weekly basis, isn't he?
Carlton 33 points clear at the final break and they moved further out when Betts struck.
Oh, bang! Betts looks up.
It came at a cost, though. Thornton and Ibbotson clashed in the lead-up. The Blue fared worse, forced off the park with the injury already blowing up.
That's come up like a cricket ball.
Betts continued to wreak havoc.
Six goals and counting.
There were a few consolation goals for Fremantle, but Carlton had the game wrapped up, cruising to their fourth straight win and condemning Frio to their fourth loss in a row. A 30-point victory keeping them well on track for a top-four finish to the season. Brett Clancy, Big Pond Sport.